one after Shel Samuelson, and we got a little war. As Hextall comes out, he threw both clubs down, and boom, he runs into Chevrier, and he's pounding away. Chevrier! And we have a war at the end of the game, and Chevrier is just getting murdered by Philadelphia's Hextall. The other goaltender, Billington, couldn't get in there as he was being held by Resch. But out of all of that, there's still a huge pile in the hash mark area along the right boards. But the major battle came out here when Hextall just took off after Alain Chevrier and buried him. So there's the calling card for the next engagement between these two, which, as we look at our records, comes February the 7th, 2 weeks from today, right back here. And we're going to have a host of penalties called at the end of the game. Well, do we get more coaches suspended now? We had a bench-clearing brawl. There can be no previous history between Chevrier and Hextall in the minor leagues. They did not play in the same league. Chevrier in Fort Wayne and the I. And Hextall, of course, in the American League at Hershey. But they're still in that corner. Samuelson was being, I don't know what started that, but Samuelson then was being driven into that far side by Steve Richmond, the defenseman, and Mel Bridgman. And then that emptied the bench, and Hextall threw his gloves with great intensity at center ice, and then boom, went after Chevrier. And right now, Kohorski is looking at Chevrier and talking to him and waving at him and pointing his finger very vociferously at the goaltender, as if to say, that's enough from you. Samuelson, with the shirt pulled in his back, looks like Quasimodo now, with his pads put up in a humpback formation. And then Tockett on the far side is in a struggle. Oh, there's the bad news. I think Tockett picked at the Devil player, Claude Loisel. And if that's picked up by Kohorski, that can be a gross misconduct. And Tockett has to be careful. He has two game misconducts. If you were to pick one up now, the Flyers already, as Mike Keenan said at the intermission, looking for bodies, they'd lose him for a suspension, which would be that game in Buffalo. Tockett wants to take a pop at Loisel and is unable. Then on the here, Knockbauer has ripped the shirt off somebody. Oh, he just drilled somebody, and I'm remiss to see who it is. But he got the shirt off his head, and as they squared off, boom, and this is an ugly scene right now. And coming right up, whoever took his jersey off, is that Verbeek? Took his jersey off and dove into that pile like Popeye going after Bluto. And he's being held off by one hand by Tim Kerr. And I'm trying to see visually who that might be. That might be John McClain. And there is, this is really unexpected. As Bridgman has held Crossman, and Daigneault's got a hold of Danico. And in that pileup at center ice, McClain is being worked on by Knockbauer. And then Carson goes down, and he's sitting on McClain, I believe, now. No, McClain's over here. I don't know who Carson's sitting on. And Tockett still in his war along the far boards with Loisel. And there goes Shel Samuelson. He's being escorted off by Jerry Gauthier. And that might be the powder cap or the detonator that started all of this. But it's surprising because there wasn't that much ill will through the game. Just six penalties. Four to Philadelphia. And we had the linesman McCourt drilled by something thrown from the stands. And now trying to fight off from Sullivan on the far side. Another Flyers enraged. Now McNabb goes in there. The non-combatants, Glenn Seabrook, is way over here in the near corner, tied up with the Devil, and Valachek is held by Daigneault. Now Lindsey Carson is being escorted off. Now McCourt, Gauthier escorted off Samuelson, and now McCourt has a hold of Carson, who's wigwagging at one of the Devils, and he won't leave, will Carson. Finally, Gauthier on the far side has gotten McClain off the rink. So the officials are trying to finish this till the morning, because the officials will have to go off, I'm sure. And if there's a supervisor here, go over just what has happened, view tapes. But since the Flyers had seen Mike Keenan suspended for this game because of an incident last Sunday at Philadelphia with far less intensity and result than this, what will come out of this? And there is Chevrier, who really took a drilling from Hextall, and now the Devils after Vadas are cheered for the performance and also for the victory, which is really the main item of the game. Johnson scoring two in the first period. The Flyers are greeted, as you might expect, with a vociferous encore vu. Johnson gave it 2-0, the 3-1 Devils into the third. Vaino, Karen went off the body of Bruce Driver to make it 3-2. McNabb on a breakaway at 9:44 to make it 4-2. And then Poulin, just 27 seconds later, brought the Flyers within one at 4-3.